In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make letterheads using your company logo and an address. So we'll make something like this. So you've got your logo and your address. We're going to use Microsoft Word and again, something at the bottom. Another style is where you might have your logo and then a graphic or an element that goes from edge to edge. This depends on to your printer, so if you can print edge to edge. But if you are sending these as PDF, which is going to be good because we save the planet, they will receive it their end as a professional looking document that would have gone edge to edge. So if we fire up Microsoft Word, now at the top and the bottom of Microsoft Word, you can see this gray area here. We double click that, we can enter what's known as the header area. You can also enter it from the tabs at the top, you'll see header footer. So if I close that and I want to enter it, I'll just double click it. Now what I'm going to do is insert a table. We want a table, so we've got the logo on the left and the text on the right. This spaces it and separates it quite nicely. And if I highlight that, one thing we don't want is we don't want any borders because we don't want to print that. So if I go like that icon there, that should clear, so I've got no borders. I'm going to grab hold of an address. If I put the address in first, we can see the spacing. If you put a border, you can go back later and click that to get rid of the... I'm now going to adjust this so it's on the right. If you want to add an icon to represent the phone, insert. We're looking for special characters in this, it's symbols. So we click symbols. I've already used them here, so you can see. But if you click down more symbols, and then depending to your system, I know this is available on the Mac as well. So if you look for like Wingdings, there's other fonts as well. Other fonts have got some weird and wonderful characters. So just go down to Wingdings. And then in this case, we want the telephone. I'll pick something different. I'll pick the round one. Insert, and that will insert that icon there. And again, if you were going to add the email, obviously unlinked, but if you're going to add your email and your web address, you can choose relevant icons that represents that. That's if you want it. And we'll just space that out there. Now the logo, if I go to insert picture from this device, which is that one there, I've got a pure white one for overlaying on photos, so obviously that wouldn't be useful. So if I move that there, that's the logo. Now at the bottom, let me see, we could put the web address at the bottom. We could have it at the top, but in this case, I just want to put something at the bottom. So if you were finished with the header and footer, you can see, just go to header footer, close that, and that's it. Now you'll see that looks a bit washed out. It will still print at the same color depth as your logo. It's just made it a bit opaque. So obviously the main focus is going to be here as you're typing. So the elements you add to the page are not a distraction. I'm just going to scroll down to the bottom, double click the bottom. You'll see that I'm in the footer area. I am going to center this and put the, let's see, I don't want no styling. Again, you can put your VAT tax numbers, company registrations or whatever. That could be at the bottom. I'm just going to do this as an example. So that's the layout. Now I just want to make sure, yeah, I might put a bit, if I double click the header again and just inch this down a bit. So now I've added a bit more white space. So there's a bit of breathing space from when this text starts. So now if I go to file, save as, but I'm going to choose to save this as a template. So if I save this as a template somewhere, let's see, this is a Batchy restaurant. If you're ever in the Kimber area, nice restaurant near Stourbridge. So if you are in that area, definitely worth going. So I'm going to save this as a template. So I'm going to save it there. Now if I exit out of this, close, you'll see it's put it as a .dotx. Now when I open that, it brings it up as a dot. Yeah, so now if I try to save that, I go file, save. If I click save, you'll see it automatically changes to save as. It won't allow me to override that template. So if you click save, you'll see it saves it as a document, file rather than a template file, so you don't have to worry about your template being overridden. So the other method is where we want edge to edge and we're using graphics. So something that you've had your designer design for you. So new document, blank. Again, we're going to use the header. There is an option in Word to go to design. You can go fill effect. If you didn't know, you can change your colors. You can go fill effect and select an image. Now, I've got Windows 11 at the moment, and this is coming up with an error. And I've tried it on 10 on another machine, and it's not given the option to change the size. So I found an alternative, which I think is probably a better way of doing it. Double click, go into your header. Now, what we want to do is select the image. So insert, picture, this device. Yeah, so now that's loaded, you can see that graphic, which is an A4 graphic in this case, is pushed or has pushed the header way down the document. And I want to be able to type on top of this graphic. So the text there you see is actually text that was in the design of the original document, the graphic, an image, an A4 high resolution image. So that's what I'm placing behind the text. So if I move that out of the way, so I need to reposition this. So if I go to, if I was at home, go to layouts, I want this image here to be behind the text. So if I select behind the text, so layout, I think look for these icons. I don't know if it's actually got a name. You'll see these type of, so I want behind the text. Now you'll see the header's reverted back to its normal size. So now I can move this graphic. So I want it to butt it right to the corner, two corners. So it's butted there and there. Scroll down, scale it so it fills the corner there. Now the header, I actually want to start obviously underneath the graphic, and I'm going to leave a bit of breathing space. So I can either double click here or go at the top here, close header footer. If I say close header footer, you'll see, if I double click that again, you'll see that's a normal brightness and stuff like that. When I close it, it'll still print it full color or full depth. What it's done, it's just made it a bit less focused, the background, so you can write your text and not be distracted. So again, same here, you would save as the template. Now, if I put some text in here, if you are finding this video helpful, do give us a thumbs up or star rating, depending which option you've got. Also in the comment, let us know your views, real printed documents or PDFs. What's your option? Bear in mind, we've got a planet we need to look after. So then you can either print, and then select your printer. If you've got a PDF writer, you might have something like Microsoft Print to PDF. Or the other option is to save as, so this PC, the style or the type of document we want is a PDF. So to the desktop. So let me just open that, bring that into shot. And as you see, it prints edge to edge. So in this case, it's gone to the bottom, that sort of, but it will go, if I put that into the edge, it prints to the edge. So at the bottom it has. So this is a nice way of giving your documents that little bit extra. Also got videos coming up on how you can use your logos at the bottom of email signatures and how your logo can look brilliant on somebody else's device if they're in dark mode. I'll see you in the next video.